Namo Sadase Sadasaspataye Cha. On 15th of September 1893, Swamiji, with taking example of a very famous story of Kupamanduko, the frog of the well, expressed his ideas on why we disagree. And I feel honored to have an opportunity like this to talk about the impact of why we disagree, or rather the impact of our disagreement. I shall expound my ideas through a story taking from Panchatantra, namely Brahmana Chaura Brahma Rakshasa Katha. The story goes like that. A poor Brahman had two cows. One day, a thief, he thought that, okay, when at night Brahman will be sleeping, I shall go and steal the two cows. And when he was yet to enter the Brahmin's house, he met one Brahma Rakshasa. Brahma Rakshasa had the intention to eat up the Brahmin. Now, enemy's enemy, my friend. They befriended each other. And when they entered the Brahmin's house, they started quarreling. Who is going to do his job first? They disagreed. And what was the result? Due to the noise, the Brahmin wake up. With the stick, he started beating up the thief. And with Ishtanama Japo, he kind of made the Rakshasa to surrender and go away. Now, what I would like to point out is that we can say that the Rakshasa who wanted to eat up the Brahman was kind, his action is kind of something yoga. He tried to do the Pratyaksha Anubhava, whereas the action of the thief, he wanted to take away the cows and then protect them and have the prosperities from the milk and other things. So his action can be equated with Kshema. And we know from the Gita, Raja Vidya Raja Gujja Yoga, Yoga Kshema Vaham Yaham, Sri Bhagavan says to Arjuna. So yoga and Kshema should be in total agreement. And here, Chora and Brahma Rakshasa, they were in disagreement. Yoga and Kshema was in disagreement. And when such kind of disagreement goes without limit, goes beyond limit, what happens? The ultimate impact, the ultimate impact is dharma sangasthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. Avatarana takes place, incarnation takes place. But we can't recognize. There were 16,000 of sages during the time of Rama. Only 12 recognized Rama to be the incarnation. When there was disagreement between the spirit and the form, the spirit of sacrifice and the form of sacrifice, the form was taken up, but the spirit lost. Then Buddha incarnated. And when in the 19th century, Thakur incarnated, that was the time of total disagreement. India was undergoing through a total challenge in terms of its age-old culture, which was Sanatana. It was challenged by the forces coming from outside, which were intolerant. And the core voice of admittance, the core voice of harmony, harmony alone being the Brahma, Brahma being the universe, harmony being the core of universe, as stated in Mandukya Upanishad, that got violated. That was the time when Avatara Varishtha Ramakrishna Deva incarnated in this very land. And Swamiji and thereafter Ramakrishna Math and Mission, they undertook the act of making harmonization of the entire world, not only the entire country, but the entire world. So I would like to conclude with one point, that is, Swamiji emphasized upon man-making education and universal individualism. These two things taken together and given proper emphasis can eradicate all the evils, all the detrimental things that occur due to our disagreement. As disagreement is something going beyond the nature of this world is totally imbibed into the harmony, and harmony is Brahman, oneness is Brahman. Disagreement is something challenging Brahman, which will be detrimental to everyone. Thank you. Pranam.